This video is sponsored by Squarespace. I want to buy both Amazon Alexa and Google Home, but they are quite expensive too, both $250 approx. But in my wallet, I have only $30. So I was wondering if it is possible to build both Alexa and Google together in a single smart speaker, even under $30. I chose wood for speaker cabinet. So first I went to a wood mill and bought a scrap wood bundle less than a dollar. It looks good to me, but after returning home, when I cut the bundle, then I saw most of the woods are defective and they are different in color. So I went back to them and bought a quality woods, just adding two more dollars, and these woods are really good. I generally do not work with wood. That's why I have very less number of woodworking tools. So I went to my nearest tool market. And after some bargain, I bought few carpentry tools at very low price. I bought a handsaw, hole making saw, wood glue, and some different grit sandpapers. Next day, I woke up early in the morning, and first, I marked the woods to 8 inches and cut it using handsaw. Then I roughed out those pieces using 60 grit sandpaper, and after some action, I used 120 grit sandpaper, and the wood pieces became this to this. Then I took some measurements and drew the outlines. Next, I cut the side excess areas using handsaw and made it round. After that, I drilled few holes and started cutting according to the measurements. It's a tedious process, and the outcome is not perfect, but it got the job done, and that can be fixed after some sanding. Then I went to the speaker market and bought two speakers that costs me around $1.20. Next, according to the speaker size, I drilled two holes. And after some sanding, hole walls became smoother. Now cutting is finished. Next, I joined those pieces using wood glue. After a while, I gathered some wood dust and mixed it with some glue. And filled those gaps. Next day, I have sanded the excess area and made it smooth. To make a LED notification ring at the front, first, I make a silicone mold, then mix some epoxy resin, and pour it onto the mold. When it hardened, then I joined it with main body. And after applying some polish, the enclosure has completed. So it's time for the electronics. To cut the price, I am using a $10 single board computer, Raspberry Pi 0W. And here comes the most challenging part. Because it does not have any audio in or audio out port, so I cannot directly use microphone and speaker on it. To sort out this limitation, I have done a lot of research and testing. that literally took me more than a month. And finally, I have designed a circuit that connects with Raspberry Pi's USB port and provide audio in and out functionality. Also, I have added power bank and audio amplification functionality into the circuit. Then, I converted the circuit into PCB and ordered it from PCBWay. They generally charge $5 for the PCB, but if we are ordering for the first time, then our PCB will be absolutely free of cost. So here I saved $5. Few days later, I got my PCB. The PCB quality was excellent and the color was very satisfying. Next, I open my component diary and collect all the required components, which costs me no more than $11. Then I started soldering. If you are interested to see how to solder SMD components, then leave a comment. I will make a dedicated video on SMD soldering. After soldering all components, I attached the microphone, two speakers, notification LED, battery, and finally the Raspberry Pi. Now circuit has finished. So next, I installed Raspbian OS in Raspberry Pi. To insert Alexa into the system, first we have to create an account in Amazon developer page. Then we will get a client ID. After that, Amazon redirects us to some steps which we need to follow to install Alexa into Raspberry Pi. After installation, we can see the status of Alexa as currently idle, which means Alexa is working. Now we need to install Google Assistant as well by going to the Google developer page and create a new project to enable the Assistant API and do the necessary steps provided by the site. The link of all the steps which you will need, you can find in the description box below. Now that the system is ready, we have to assemble the required items inside the cabinet that we prepared. While doing this one by one, let us talk about Squarespace. Today's video sponsor. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform for creating your own domain, website, or an online store. They have beautiful templates and a lot of customization tools. And it is helpful for those who don't know how to code and still want a beautiful looking website for their company, side business, or anything of that sort. If you still need any help, you can contact their award-winning 24/7 customer helpline service. When you will make your order, don't forget to use coupon code DDElectroTech for additional 10% discount. Finally, the assembly is ready. I really love the look of the speaker, especially the light ring. How do you find it? Let me know in the comment section. Now it's time to test it and compare it with the original Amazon Echo and Google Home. Alexa, what is the time?
It's 4:44 p.m.
Hey Google, how are you?
I'm well, thanks. How can I help?
You also control your home appliances, like Alexa, switch on the light.
Okay.
Make the light red.
Okay.
The sound quality is also very good with a very good bass. Play I Need Only You.
I Need Only You by Love Beans, starting now.
People talk and tell what you wanna hear now. We better stick together, let's come whatever. We're not coming home tonight. We're living quick in the world, gotta get it right now. We only need.
The major difference between my speaker and Alexa or Google Home is that my speaker has built-in battery, so I can take it anywhere, but Google Home and Amazon Echo does not have any battery. They always need a power supply. So it's time for the giveaway and declare previous winner name. Congratulations to Abhishek Shah for winning the tablet of the previous giveaway. We will be contacting you. Today, we are going to give 3 Amazon Echo Dot to 3 lucky subscribers. All you need to do is comment down below and share this video. So that's it for now. See you in our next video. Until then, bye bye.